All right, question 11, take two. Nickel batteries. The hypothesis will be about mu1 and mu2. The null hypothesis is given below. You can see here, mu1 is equal to mu2. Provide the alternative hypothesis and a complete definition for mu1. So the first thing we should probably do is define what mu1 and mu2 are. So mu1, so mu is essentially just the population mean, and 1 denotes the population of cadmium batteries, and 2 denotes the population of hydride batteries, which you can figure out just by reading the problem. So mu1 is essentially just the population mean that only refers to cadmium batteries. So mu1 is equal to the population mean. Population mean talking time. Talking time is our parameter of interest. Talking time for all cell phones with cadmium batteries. So after we finish defining what mu1 and mu2 are, we need to figure out what the alternative hypothesis is. So you will refer back to this last part of the question. Independent random samples of batteries for each battery type were tested in hopes that the average talking time for the new hydride battery was longer than for the old cadmium type. So remember, the hydride battery, that refers to 2, and the cadmium type is just 1. So these researchers are hypothesizing that the talking time for the new hydride battery, which would be mu2, is longer than that for the old cadmium type, which is denoted by mu1. So if they are theorizing that mu2 is bigger than mu1, that would just be our alternative hypothesis. So you would just write mu1 is smaller than mu2. So that's part A. Next, we'll move down to part B. So the research assistant who is generating the SPSS output created these three QQ plots shown below. Which QQ plot would be used for checking the assumptions for this test? So QQ plots, as a reminder, are used to check normality of the population. And incidentally, if you are interested in using this test, you have to make sure that the populations that you're getting the samples from are also normal. So you need to make sure that both populations are normal. And you'll note that for plot 3, that's a QQ plot of talk time for the 45 batteries combined. So that's not what you want. You don't want the combined populations. You want separate populations. So in this case, we'll be using plot 1 and plot 2. Plot 1 is a QQ plot of talk time for only cadmium batteries, and plot 2 is a QQ plot for just hydride batteries. So we'll want both of these QQ plots in order to test our assumption that the two populations are normal. So the answer here would just be number 1, plot 1 and plot 2. All right, that's it.